Good evening. I'm Vicki Dorn.
And I'm Rick Van Hoos. A horrific beating. That's how Metro Police described what happened at a convenience store in the city's Smoketown neighborhood.
WLKY's Steve Bergen found several people were involved. He's here with reaction from one of the victims. Steve?
Vicki, Rick. A store clerk was badly beaten. The store owner had a gun smashed across her face.
I felt so helpless because there were so many of them.
Julie Cater says she watched as a group of people entered her Smoketown store and severely beat her clerk.
He is so tiny, and he has polio.
It was a horrible, horrific assault that several blunt objects were used, and there was also a weapon involved.
Police say Solomon Tequil was behind the counter when he was beaten with a handgun, 5-gallon bucket, even the telephone. He was also stabbed with an umbrella. And when Cater tried to intervene?
Yeah, I got hit right here in the lip. I just had my stitches out Monday.
About 30 stitches in all, but her injury pales in comparison to what happened to her clerk.
They had to literally staple his head using numerous medical staple guns and lots of defensive wounds to the hands.
Tequil also suffered facial fractures and cracked ribs. Metro police have arrested four people. Crystal Adams, age 39, 25-year-old Eric Haynes, 21-year-old Donisha Lester, and 18-year-old Jessica Lester. They are seeking 44-year-old Eric Lester and 24-year-old Erica Adams. Also wanted is this man who was caught on store surveillance video.
The assault occurred on the 10th, and there had been a previous argument.
Police would not elaborate on the previous altercation. Cater says whatever the dispute, it should have been handled differently.
You don't have to resort to this aggressive violence.
Now the suspects are facing numerous charges. Some of them will have to answer to attempted murder. Police are asking if you have any information on those three people still wanted in connection with this case to call 574-LMPD. Steve Bergen, WLKY News.
Now, Julie Cater and her husband have owned the Smoketown Dollar Plus on South Preston Street for 5 years. Along with this most recent incident, they had an armed robbery in 2009.